Pretty girls just happen to stop by in the hood, and they thought they could get till tomorrow. Just a picture perfect day, that's a whole lifetime. And it never is, so we have to do is hit rewind. So let's just stay in the moment, smoke some weed, drink some wine. Reminisce, talk some shit, whatever, yeah, it's in your mind. Keep them all, they can't erase, keep the space in all times. So when the record girls cut, I'll be fine. Forever young.
Let me call. Let me call. I saw you. I didn't know.
From the finest cars, from the Now, before we proceed in this event, what a tradition in this great university to begin every of our functions with prayers. And the good news is that we have a lot of Reverend Fathers in our midst today. And permit me to call on... Sorry, please. So please, before we go into that, please, let's take the national anthem. And then Fulbright anthem will follow. Very quickly, please. The national anthem. Shall we please?
Introduce to us
members of the High Table seated here today. Now the University Vice Chancellor, Engineer Professor Abafreri Ruke, is unavoidably absent at this event today, but ably represented by the Deputy Vice Chancellor in charge of administration of this university. She is no other person than Professor Mrs. Doris Ogeleka. Let's recognize her presence. She is the chief host of this event today. Now, we also have in our midst here the registrar of this great university. Mrs. Omoyine Yijin, entrepreneurship of this university. He is actually Professor D. Let's recognize his presence in our midst. Professor Ikeke. You are welcome, sir. We also have our distinguished scholar who is the guest speaker for this occasion seated here today. The director in charge of work services. Let's recognize Prince of Architects. Only have a February in this year. We have also the initial investment. One more time, let's recognize the presence here. We have for this lecture, this annual lecture series, Mrs. Chinwe Lumoko, recognize her presence here. And then we also have the Dean of Student Affairs, who also doubles as the Chairman of the Academic Staff Union Universities, ASU, Fubri Chapter, is not a person than ASU. Engineer Dr. Omonimo Otanoja, who is also Director of Fubri Energy Solutions. MD Fubri Enterprises. Okay. Let's recognize his presence here. And then we also have in our midst the director in charge of counseling and human development center. She's no other person than Dr. Mrs. Maria Okocha. Let's recognize her presence here. That also from my directorate seated here, the head, Mr. Amora Victor, is seated here, Director of Media and Public Relations, and other members of staff that are seated here today. Your presence is highly recognized. Welcome your presence here. Members of the press, I can see Mr. Chidi Okafor of the Guardian newspaper seated here. And all students, your presence is highly welcome. So at this point, I want to quickly call on the director, who is the undertaker of this event now, or the director of general studies, the entrepreneurship, to come and give us his welcome address. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together to make welcome Professor. Is that the best you can do?
Good morning, Mr. Vice Chancellor, Engineer Professor Rim Ruke Akofure, who is ably represented here by the acting Deputy Vice Chancellor Administration, Professor Doris Fowe Ogeleka. Philosophy, and he also is a parish priest of St. Jude. Catholic Church, GROA, Efo. I also remind of the guest lecturer. Guest lecturer, you are welcome. Professor, 6 years ago, by the need to key into a global academic tradition of seeking solutions to society's myriad problems through intellectual discourse. Today's event marks a courageous response by the entire university community to shake off the general distress and gloom the fuel subsidy removal has cast over our national space and continue our collective quest to intellectually estray one of the issues that has threatened our collective peace and national well-being. In the light of the commendable resilience, I wish to thank you for finding time to be here. It was our original goal to make this lecture series an annual event. Unfortunately, we were unable to hold it in the last 3 years, owing to the disruptions of avoidable strikes and the incidence of COVID-19. It is therefore gratifying that we have been able to put ourselves together again to continue this academic tradition. I do not wish to bore you with a long speech by focalizing the topic of our discourse today. Our distinguished guest lecturer will do justice to the topic. But permit me to observe that as a university whose mandate is to train manpower for the oil and gas industry in Nigeria, the question of peace between host communities and oil and gas communities in the Niger Delta is not only imperative, but seamless operations of the oil and gas activities. It does robustly align with the core mandate of this university. This moral financial fatherly support to the Directorate of General Studies and Entrepreneurship. I also wish to thank our principal officer. Let me also salute our staff and the members of the planning committee. Professor Mrs. Chinelo Woku, Mr. Emmanuel Esebedafe, Secretary, for the sacrifices they all made to see the success of today's ceremony. I invite you to sit back and enjoy today's lecture, because you are going to take home what I call integrity. You are going to take home with what I call trust. You are going to take home with what I call diversity. You are going to take home with what I call ingenuity. You are going to take...
Let's give our director a bigger round of applause. Quickly correct something, because we have a lot of students here who we need to know, have this information. I had to introduce Engineer Dr. Omolego Tanuja to us, but he is actually the director in charge of student industrial workers of FOPRI. Please, one more time, let's recognize his presence. He's our director, CES, of this great. Director, architect, planning and development department of this university. One more time, please, let's properly recognize him. And of course, Tessie Yepaguru is from the Public Relations Department. So, please, at this point, I want to quickly call on the chairman of this occasion to come forth and give us his own welcome remark. Let's invite Reverend Father Professor Mark Ipig as he comes to talk to us.
Thank you. Permit me to stand, even though I'm the chairman of the occasion. I want to welcome all of us to this special, wonderful occasion. And thank our Vice Chancellor, Professor Rim Ruke. It is by his power and strength I'm here in the directorate as a staff on sabbatical. I'm from Delta State University, Abraka. And I want to equally thank the Deputy Vice Chancellor at me, Professor Mrs. Doris Ogeneka. And thank our registrar, Dr. Mrs. Omoyenijen, for his assistance to me to make me acclimatized to this place. And I want to thank my able director, Associate Professor Moni. And permit me to adopt the protocol that has been well established by the MC and my director. I consider it a great privilege to be asked to be chairman on this occasion. I was telling the director yesterday that thank you for making me the chairman of the occasion, because I have another something I will add to my CV. That is on a lighter mode. Apart from that, of course, being here, I will acquire experience also, and all of us who have come, experience, knowledge, friendship, the warmth, and the network. The importance of knowledge can never be overemphasized. I believe that for many of us who have gathered here this morning, and what we are doing here, of course, goes beyond here to the whole world. In the Holy Bible, of which many of us believe in the Holy Bible, in Proverbs 4:7, we are told that wisdom is the principal thing. With all your getting, get understanding. And in Daniel 11:32, scripture says the people who know their God will do exploits. So that speaks about the power of knowledge. And in Deuteronomy 6:7, Moses was instructing the people of Israel. He told them, this word you are hearing, keep teaching them diligently to your children's children, of course, in order to create a better society. We are all familiar with the story that as a young boy at the age of 12, Jesus was already in the temple, and he was listening to the scriptures being explained. He was equally teaching others. We call the society in which we live a knowledge society. Knowledge society. No matter where human beings are able to go, one of the greatest assets we have is what? Knowledge. Knowledge. So that is why I want to encourage us as we have gathered here this morning to actually pay attention, actively engage in the lecture. I believe that each and every one of us, there is something we will learn to take home. And we live in a society today in which head labor is actually often higher than hand labor. Because head labor, which is intellectual labor, of course, is what will give you the insight, understanding, right judgment, and ability, of course, to work anywhere you find yourself in life. Why is this topic very, very important? On a personal note, I consider this topic to be very important. From my own life experience, of course, my area of specialization is environmental ethics and social ethics. And many years ago, I studied education for justice and peace at master's level. at Fordham University in New York. And some years back, I was Director of Justice, Development and Peace in my diocese, the Catholic Diocese of Warri. So any topic I ask to do with peace, justice, development, conflict, of course, is very, very important. And it's equally important to all of us. One of the greatest longing of the world is peace. Many of us have been trained, we become engineers, we become scientists, we become whatever discipline we specialize in technology, for instance. We are going to work among people, not just machines. Is that not true? We work among people. And the way we relate to these people in our various organizations matters. That is why we need to be informed about peace. Peace, of course, is what the Yoruba people call Ufuoma, and for the Hebrew people, it's called Shalom. So we need to mainstream issues of peace. And the importance of human relationships can never be overemphasized. And every organization in which we may work, we are working or we may work tomorrow, has a responsibility to foster corporate social responsibility. So while thanking the university, I thank all of you who have made the sacrifice to come. I wish all of us during this hour a happy listening to the lecture, happy interaction, and fruitful friendship. Amen. Thank you.
Let's do something better for our Reverend Father and our Professor. Who has been doing this as the chairman of this occasion. So at this point, I want to call on our acting Vice Chancellor here today now. Representing the VC, Deputy Vice Chancellor, Professor Mrs. Doris Gelegat, comes to give us the Vice Chancellor's welcome address.
Lecture series. Let it not be all talk, talk, talk. what we talk. Thank you very much.
Let's give our Deputy Vice Chancellor a better round of applause. So at this point, we're moving on to the lecture proper on peace and conflict resolution between host communities and oil and gas companies in the Niger Delta, a humanistic perspective. And to give a citation on the guest lecturer of today, let's make welcome our associate professor introduced to us earlier, Joachim Okusumoye, as he comes to read the citation of our guest lecturer.
Friends, citation of Professor Kingsley Ufoma Omoyibo. Professor Kingsley Ufoma Omoyibo was 1966 in Warri, Delta State, to the family of late Mr. Augustine Emoto and Eunice Emoti Jade Omoyibo. He attended Etio Primary School, Sample, from 1990 to 1976 before proceeding in development. His area of teaching and research include development psychology, sociology, gender research 2017 to 2021. Currently, he is co-editor of Journal of Religions and Journal of Multidisciplinary Studies, Faculty of Education, Ambusali University, ECOMA, and Journal of Infotech, and co-edited over the World Bank / African Development Bank, ADB, in collaboration with the Forestry out a study on the community participation on the management of forest reserve, member National Universities Commission, NUC, accreditation team. And since 2021 till date, he serves as facilitator for the World Bank funded project on sustainable procurement, environmental and social standards enhancement, SPESE, domiciled under the Center of Excellence, University of Benin, Nigeria. Professor Omoyibo has served in various boards and committees within and outside the university community. He served as the head of the Department of Sociology and Anthropology between July 2017 and June 2019. He is a member of some learned societies / professional associations, such as Nigeria Anthropology, NASA, 1991, Sociological Association, GSA, 2002, member, Nigeria Institute of Management, Shatta, 1995, member, Nigeria Institute of Industrial Administration, NIAN, 2008, and member, Nigerian Rural Sociological Association, NROSA, 2014. Currently, Professor Omoyibo is the Chair, Academic Program and Planning Committee, APPC, Faculty of Social Sciences, University of Benin, Nigeria. He awards distinctions. He is happily married to engineer Dr. Gwyneth Kingsley Omoyibo. And the marriage is blessed with children. And so I present our guest lecturer to you.
Chancellor, that photo will address you as, and I know you are presenting a very effective Vice Chancellor, Professor Rim Roke Apofore. Today I knew, I am happy that I met you, not just as a sister and a friend, and as a DVC, but I'm meeting you as a home girl, and apart from that too, that of course we are both alumnus, you know, from the university, great university of Benin. And so we are servicing the world. We are servicing the world. Today is a great day, but before I commence my lecture, I love to stand on protocols, but I don't stand on existing protocols. I want to recognize especially the host of this particular event, the Vice Chancellor, like I mentioned, who will join us soonest, Professor Apofore, and of course, the principal members of management, the registrar, the chief librarian, professors here present, and of course, I must equally give it to the directorate that considered me worthwhile to come here to do the needful. The director in the person of Associate Professor Moni Udi, the chairman of this particular occasion, who happens to be a very wonderful father to me, as much as the fact that he's the chairman, very Reverend Professor Ikeke. And of course, I recognize to one of my very own here, Professor Shinelo Mokolo, fantastic. Who of course too is a great connect from the University of Benin School of Thought. I recognize all of you, the professors. I recognize all of you, the directors. And I must recognize all of you are the ones that make things happen, and today is going to be a great day. I am going to my paper, and my paper is I will try my best possible to ensure that I do it in a very simplistic manner. In my presentation, and what do I mean? I will try, yes, I can see that there's a reorganization. Peace. Most to all of this, I am sure, series is on peace and conflict resolution between host communities in the Niger Delta. It was true that we never thought that a time like this will come when subsidy removal will become an issue. Not just an issue of conflict. People. There is no peace anywhere. There is no that you ask, why did I say so? I am inherently saying that conflict is pervasive. There is conflict everywhere. And I will try to consider simple language. Our lives. And before I say that conflict is part of our lives, and it's a system that actually runs in our own system as human beings, I want to create another caveat to tell you that there cannot be peace. And there cannot be peace without war if there is no humanity. In other words, we must be human beings first before we become scientists. There is the humanness, there is the dignity, there is the value. I have not started to rendict all of that. One of the most sought-after commodity in the world, the most sought-after commodity in the world just now, globally, is that word you call peace, the concept you call peace. what I refer to as developing the culture of peace. The world today is engulfed. It's engulfed in a series of conflicts. And some of us do not get it very clearly. Therefore, by the time I wrote the paper on what you call the oil and gas industry, which you and I know, which is the mono economy that sustains what you call the Nigerian state. And what do I mean by mono economy? That's not to say we don't have other sources of revenue, but you know that is the heart and that's the hub. And the Niger Delta, as it is the soul where that is being tapped from. And because of that, we have a lot of crisis. If you like, you call it crisis. But let me give you a simple definition of conflict. I am trying to do that to find the paper. Because as you see later, you will now understand the point that Professor Ikeke made when he said he was a student and still a professor of justice and peace. Conflict itself, most times we say, is antagonistic. And people with incompatible interests, contradictory interests. Beyond that,